Every movement we make is with a purpose, dog. Every stance is with a purpose, dog. When you buckle your chin strap up, it's with a purpose, dog.
Uh-huh.
Do you feel me?
Yeah.
Do you feel me?
Yeah.
Do you feel me?
Yeah.
That's the facts, nigga. Give a fuck about these rap niggas. No. Cause half the ones I seen, pussy, I just want a bitch that say I love it when you seen pussy. And it's like niggas never seen pussy. Down talking other niggas, why you gotta reach pussy? But let me get back to this real shit. I was on a field trip, my dad was on a guilt trip. They wonder why I never feel shit. It's crazy how that deadbeat can still produce this real shit. Music of my life, at least it ain't no damn shit. This for the ones who really never had a chance, shit. Like fuck a gun, that knuckle up and throw your hand, shit. Like fuck a later, handle shit right where you stand, shit. Like fuck it, I'm adapting while they crashing. Family over everything, forever be my fraction. What if I subtracted all that shit that got y'all sacking? If the screen up on my phone was really all I had cracking up, would you still fuck with me? This one a bitch that say she love me and she stuck with me. Now I got new niggas trying to see what's up with me. Then they telling other niggas how they always fuck with me. I guess we all human. Just look at everything we ruined. When Manny got killed and I was sitting at the viewing with his name up on my teeth from all this bullshit that's brewing. That's all bad. Man, I say everything is all bad. And watch them niggas always drinking out of tall glass. They thirsty, And don't be judging like a court, cause I'ma tell your ass to go and get a jersey. Like y'all gon' need game, y'all gon' need game. Get your head about your tail, boy, we all gon' see change. From where they speak pain, just so they could get some pleasure. The quitting niggas always saying effort to the effort. I hope that you affected by the message. Words in the sky, I'll be damned if I text it. I said it's in the sky, so I'm hoping that y'all catch it. Sending in my records, but I'm hoping God bless it. I'm hoping God bless it. We all gon' see change. You just keep acting like we not. I ain't talking about no struggle, I ain't talking about no block. Ay, nigga in the bubble, ay, nigga tryna pop. Learn to recognize an ocean full of lies. When the women I was stroking had no hope up in her eyes. That nigga stay afloat because that boat that just arrived. Nigga dead up on the land, look at the vultures in the sky. Dried out feelings, these the moments that I cry. No, these the moments that I rise to the truth. Looking in the skies to the God for my truth. Then I think to myself, I thank God I'm the proof. I thank God I'm a, I show you all my pain. And I show you all my shame. And now I'm stuck up in the game with all this shit up on my brain. Like we all gon' see change. Like we all gon' see change.
There's a fear tonight in Kansas City that Chief Safety Eric Berry has lymphoma. The team says Berry's going to see a specialist in Atlanta after finding a mass in his chest. Berry's on the non-football injury list. He won't play again this year.
Short time ago, the Chiefs placed Eric Berry on NFI, non-football injury list, which means he will be sidelined for the remainder of the season. And what that means is, essentially, during the Chiefs' Thursday night loss at Oakland, during the Raiders' game-winning 17-play drive, Eric Berry came to the sidelines afterwards and complained about chest pains. So the Chiefs gave him an x-ray the next day back in Kansas City, which they then sent him for an MRI and then a CAT scan and then a blood test. And they now believe that he does have lymphoma. They are sending him to see a specialist in Atlanta tomorrow. It will be the next 24 to 48 hours in which they fully determine exactly what is wrong with him. They are right now hoping for the best, but expecting the worst in regards to him. And a short time ago, Eric Berry did release this statement, and I read, "I am truly thankful for all the support from family, friends, coaches, teammates, and the entire Chiefs kingdom. At first, I was in shock with the diagnosis on Saturday and did not even want to miss a game, but I understand that right now I have to concentrate on a new opponent. I've got great confidence in the doctors and the plan they're going to put in place for me to win this fight. I believe that I am in God's hands, and I have great peace in that. I know my coaches and teammates will hold things down here the rest of the season and until I'm back running out of the tunnel at Arrowhead. I'm so thankful and appreciative of being a part of this franchise and playing in front of the best fans in the NFL. I will be back."
I mean, it's not a lot of people that can say that they came back from an injury like that and still maintain the level of play. It just makes the story that much more exciting. Coming in, making Pro Bowl as a rookie, getting hurt, bouncing back and making a Pro Bowl again, and then making a Pro Bowl again after that. You know, I feel like it's not that many people that can say that. So, it was a tough time. It was very difficult to come back from. It was very draining mentally. But, I mean, it made me stronger and it made me a better person as well. So, outside of the football field, I feel like it helped me grow up as a man.
To the Kansas City Chiefs, one of the highest paid safeties in the NFL. Really talented kid. He got diagnosed with cancer, lymphoma. Could no longer play in the NFL, had to start going through chemo. Started losing his hair, started losing his muscle mass. But this is the same guy I watched leave chemotherapy, and he would leave chemo and go jump out on the track and run 400 meters after he left chemo. And he would be crying as he was running around the track, but the tears wasn't because he was in so much pain. The tears wasn't because he wanted to give up. The tears were because he couldn't kick it in gear like he used to. But this is the same guy when they diagnosed him cancer-free and he went back to the NFL, he returned back to the NFL a pound heavier. What is that?
So can I get a fucking encore? 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 Man is here. Started from FIFA to top of the tier. Got all of these stats. How did you do it? It's all that I hear. Man's doing everything. Going from Butch to what's making that move with it. Flying from Vegas to Napa to partying. Watching the progress or showing the Guardian. But that's all news. Firstborn bringing the bread to the table. Viewing the short and the low of the man from the high counting piece on the top of the label. You gotta admit it. Nothing untrue when I go to just spit it. Then my team is just killing it. Bob is just killing it. Part of the moon and I'm here to fulfill it. So can I get a fucking encore? Can I get a fucking encore? Can I get a fucking encore? Can I get a fucking encore?
To remind them, this my last encore, no more rewinding. We've been doing this for time and time again. About time they were tuning in. About time they were noticing that I've been going in. I'm back now and I'm closing in to the high places I'm supposed to be in. So don't insult me again. Yeah, hindsight, trying to get a better image, trying to make me forget that I'm legendary. Won't stop till they see me in the cemetery. I'm mindful, no haters ever getting to me. It's a new level that I've been on. No more checkpoints, this here is D1. Yeah, I'm my own man now. Do whatever I want.
So can I get a fucking encore?